Let's add time constraints. So far we only added activities. Let's generate a timetable and check it. Before caring about the teacher's timetable, we need to care about the student's timetable. The most difficult part is setting up the correct student's structure in FET. Some guys remember it much too late and spend a lot of time into caring about a nice teacher table, but overview a long time that the student's data is totally wrong. So let's check student's table first. If you do a timetable the first time, please check all students' tables. View the tables. I guess you also noticed bugs, there are a few subgroups with gaps. But gaps are not allowed for students at my school. So I need to add a gaps constraint. But I won't do it for all students because of two reasons. First of all, I will need a pseudo student's year later to care about teacher reserve. That doesn't need a gaps constraint. I will explain that in another video. Second of all, you can see that several students can't ever get a gap because their table is full. I have got 5 days and 6 hours per day. So in total 30 hours per week. Let's have a quick look into the students' statistics. You can see that many subgroups have got 30 hours per week. So gaps are impossible for these students. So I need to care only about years that contain subgroups with less than 30 hours. If I add gaps constraints for students with 30 hours per week, then, a little bit, time will be wasted for checking an unbreakable constraint. There are two variants to care about that. 1. Add max gaps constraints for needed years. 2. Give that student a pseudo activity, an activity without a teacher. Maybe with subject name free, and add also a time constraint so this activity is always in the last hour. I prefer variant 1 for this dataset. Other datasets might use the second variant. Before generating again, I want to show you also how to find such a bug by checking the statistics. You can find a student's statistics in the FET results folder. As you can see, there are gaps in students' statistics. You can now track down it a bit more and also see the groups and subgroups with the gaps. Don't forget that in fact it just might be luck that there is no gap in the student's timetable. So please think carefully. But now let's generate the table again. Don't close the web browser with the statistics. Just press reload of the F5 key after the calculation is finished. You can see that the student's statistics is fine now, there are no gaps anymore. Even if there are a lot of other things we should check in the student's table, I want to care about the teachers now. You can see in the teacher's statistics that there are some teachers with a lot of gaps. Of course that is not nice and it should be lower, but I won't add a max gaps constraint now. Those constraints are very difficult to calculate. Generating your timetable will take much more time, and I don't want to waste my time in waiting while I still need to hunt other critical bugs. The teacher's gaps constraints, the teacher's min hours and max hours per day constraint are always the very last constraints that I add. Don't add them now. There are some other teachers' time constraints that should be added now, since they might be impossible with your current activity planning, and you will understand and fix them easily if you add them now. Teacher Julia is a trainee teacher and she must visit another school on Monday. So she isn't available on Monday. So I add a not available time constraint and generate again. Generate and check the timetable. Don't add too many constraints at once. As you can see, generating doesn't need much time at the moment, and it will be very easy to understand impossible constraints if you add them step by step. It will be more difficult to locate the problem if you add a lot of constraints at the same time. Some teachers are part-time teachers only, and they are allowed to have a free day if they work less than a certain number of hours. So I add a max working days constraint for these teachers. Generate the table once again and check if all is fine. Check the statistics or the timetables. Don't forget, don't add too many constraints at once. If generating sadly fails, it is much more difficult to understand and fix the bug. Of course, still several teachers' constraints are missing, like the min hours, and max gaps constraints, but like I said, don't add them now. They will only slow down, and we need to care about other constraints first. But this will be contents of the next videos. Happy timetabling!